Good afternoon, students. So, class is about environment policies of the country or order. Okay. Analytical analysis of recursive algorithms. Okay. So this concept is very important. And at morning discussed about that program. Okay. See here in this factorial program, what we have to do is here how to calculate recursive mathematical analysis. Factorial. Okay. Yeah. So, what is the first you have to choose the input size, then the, what is the basic operations? You have to
do one first one decide.
You get input size, then identify the basic operation, then the number of times the operation is executed.
Okay.
So, first one is the input size is
n. And the basic operation is f(n-1).
Then how many
step 3 check whether the number of times the basic operation is performed. The
number of times we want to calculate
number of computations
and then we come to the factorial.
Okay. So that is see here.
For example, we want to calculate the pi factorial. Okay, so what we do is by that means by 4 into 3 into 1. If n equal to 0 means it returns 1. Here n value is 5, so come here. So if you want to calculate n factorial, by factorial, first you have to know. Four factorial value. You want to calculate the three factorial. You want to three factorial value. You want to calculate the two factorial. You want to factorial value. You want to
one factor.
So in this, how to do? So here
I am calculating to compute n minus 1. For here, 5 is there, we will take 4 factorial, that is half n. So that is half n. So we need the function pass
plus 1 is for multiplication.
5 into 4, 2, 3 into 2 into 1.
So for example, how to multiply that value to this number. Then you get the value.
So that's why I am entering plus 1 to multiply.
F of n minus 1 by n. That is 5 into 4 factorial, 4 into 3 factorial, 3 into 2 factorial, 2 into 1 factorial.
So, every time you have to multiply by 1, so that's why
that means f of n equal to m of n minus 1 plus
for n greater than 0.
For n equal to just return 1.
The n value is 0, return 1, if n greater than 0. You have to perform m of n minus 1 plus n operations here. So m of n minus 1 to compute function f of n minus 1. And this is for multiplication by n.
Okay. Here.
Okay, okay. Now it's clear. My voice is clear, students.
See. See the students here. Okay, students. You substitute m of n minus 1 in one place, then you get the value is m of n minus 1. Here, just write n instead of n plus 1. Just write instead of n, you just write the n minus 1. Just write here, this is equation 1, our equation 1, substitute the equation 1 here, then n plus n minus, that is m of n minus 2. That is m of n minus 2 plus 1, this is our. Okay, just store this value in n minus 1 place. So this, in this place you have to store. So this value, this is the value you get here. Okay, that is m of n minus 2 plus 2. Then substitute m of, instead of in equation 1, substitute n equal to n minus 2 in equation 1. You get the value m of n minus 3 plus 1, then substitute here n minus 2 place. So this value you get here. So similarly, the process is going on.
this process in this way to get this value is repeated. I'm considering it value the I. So m of n minus 1 plus I at some substitution we get I value. Then finally we get the n value. That is m of n minus 1 and minus n. So you get 0 m of 0 here. You get here m of 0 plus n. M of 0 means n value is 0. So n value 0 means you have you perform any multiplication there. You cannot perform any multiplication. So that is 0. So 0 plus 1, that is n. This is the recurrence relation for factorial program. Okay, next coming to towers of Hania problem. So what is the procedure is here? What the procedure is here is that we have so we have three towers are there, and in one tower we have different parameter of discs are there, different sizes of discs are there. So just move source here. Three towers are there. One is source, destination, auxiliary. Okay. So we have n discs of different sizes that can be slide onto any of three pegs. So consider, we are considering A as source and B as auxiliary and C as destination. So all the discs on the first peg, this one, so in order of size, the largest on the bottom and the smallest on the top. So the goal is to move all the discs to the third peg using the auxiliary peg as mediator. Okay, so what we have to do is we just move this disc to a destination by using auxiliary as a mediator. Okay, so this is the algorithm for towers of Hania problem. So here first, if n equal to 1, is there any one move, one disc is there, you directly move the disc from A to C without deviating. Here this is my source one, this is my source, and this is my destination, and this is my auxiliary. So first, if n equal to 1, directly move A to C. Otherwise, if n greater than 1, move n minus 1 disk. So for example, we have three disks are there. So that is here I am writing here. The size are 3, 2, 1 different sizes. So one is I'm just doing here A and C. This one is B. Okay. So move n minus disk from A to B using C as mediator. So n minus one disk we move to here. That is first I kept one disk here and two disks here, and I kept okay. Next I store this one disk here. So what I am using C. So you just have n minus disk A to B using C. So this is B, this is C. So I move n minus disk from A to B by using C as mediator. Okay. Then move n minus disk from B to C by using C as mediator. Then move nth disk from A to C. So then I move this disk here. This disk contains only 3. That 3 disk I move to 3. Then this is C, and I remaining disk I taken from this one and store here. So the remaining disks are B to C. So after that, we just towers B to using B to C using A as mediator, then that is the final solution for the problem. Okay, so what we have to do is here, we just move one disk at a time. You cannot kept a larger disk and smaller disk. You can place the smaller disk and larger disk. First, you have to move n minus one disk from source to the auxiliary by using destination as mediator. Then move nth disk from one disk, that is the nth disk, n disk from destination source to destination. Then move n minus one disk from auxiliary to the destination. So this is our concept. Okay. So what are the, how we can analyze this algorithm? So how we analyze this one? So see here. So algorithm analysis here, the number of moves we can move, the what is M of N is, how many number of moves can be used to move n disk from source to the destination, that is our M of N. So here M of N is depends on N only. We get the following recursive relation, that is M of N equal to M of N minus 1, means that is this is the move from source to auxiliary memory is, we can move is M of N minus 1 disk plus and one disk from source to destination, one disk at a time, plus from auxiliary memory to the destination is M minus N 1 moves for N greater than 1. Okay. So this move, this M of N minus moves from source to auxiliary one disk at a time, that is plus 1, plus from auxiliary to destination N minus 1 moves. Total you get is 2M of N minus 1 plus 1 for N greater than 1. If you have only one disk, that is M of 1 equal to 1. Okay, clear students? So by backward substitution, you just place N equal to N minus 1 here. That is, this is our equation 1. So this is our equation 1. Just substitute here N equal to N minus 1. Okay. So substitute here N equal to N minus 1. So here what you get is N minus 2, 2M minus 2 plus 1. And substitute in equation 1 instead of M minus 1. So M minus 1, we substitute this value. That is 2, 2, that is 2 into 2, M of N minus 2, that is 2 plus 1, 2. Okay, so we multiply this one. So 2 into 2, that is 2 square, M of N minus 2 plus 2 into 1 is 2 plus this one. Okay, so just remind this one is that it is. Then substitute N equal to N minus 2 in equation 1, we get 2 of N minus 2, these values substitute here. Instead of M minus 2 step, you just write these values. That is 2M of N minus 2 plus 1, and previously plus 2 plus 1, you multiplied it 2Q plus 2Q plus, and this is 2 square plus remaining value, it is this one. So we get the value this one. See here, 1 minute student. Okay, see the expression, students.
Yes, so see the expression here, instead of n minus 2, you place there and we get that value. Then consider m of n minus 3 value. Okay, then see, replace n minus 3 value, then substitute in the equation 1. Okay. Okay, press do it, students. 1 minute. Okay, so substitute n minus 3 value. Then what you have to get see here in this. N minus 3 rest weight. Just see the expression. Wait for 1 minute. So you get the value is and here and after substituting the n minus 3 value you get 2 for substitute in the equation 1 instead of m minus 3 you get see here in this m of n minus 3 that is 2 cube plus 2 square plus 2 plus 1 then if you consider the next n equal to n minus 4 similarly you get here in here the value is increasing here so here 4 we will get here also 4 and here the value is less than this value so I am considering 2 power I m of n minus I plus 2 power I minus 1 plus 2 power I minus 2 and so on I am getting plus 2 plus 1 okay students clear that is 2 power I m of n minus I am replacing 3 with I minus 1 then 2 with I minus 2 and so on we get the value is 2 power m of n minus 1 plus 2 power I minus 1 so here initial condition specified is n equal to 1 so which is achieved for I equal to n minus 1. Okay. So if you want to get m of 0 value, so we get the values m of 1 values here. We get m of 1 equal to 1. If you want that one, we replace the I with n minus 1. Okay. So that is I done here. I equal to n minus 1 and substitute in this equation. That is 2 power that is 2 power n minus 1 and I equal to n minus 1 so you get 2 power n minus 1
value there. Store, if you want to get the n equal to 1, you get replace I equal to n minus 1. I equal to n minus 1, substitute in this 2 power I m of n minus I plus 2 power I minus 1. You just substitute here and you get the value is 2 power n minus 1 m of 1 plus 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. That is m of 1 equal to, already in the above expression you know m of 1 equal to 1. That is 2 power n minus 1 plus 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. That is 2 power n minus 1. So the complexity of this algorithm is 2 power n minus 1. Okay, clear students, are any doubt? So far clear? Just see the expression, you can easily understand. Just to solve by yourself with hand, this expression. If you have any doubt, just ping me a message, just solve this example by your own hand, then you can understand. Okay. Just practice, I'm staying in a line. Sir, okay, carry on. Any doubt, please write a message in chat box. So see, next example for recursive algorithm, that is binary representation of positive digital number. So an investigation of a recursive version of algorithm. So another example for recursive algorithm. So here an investigation of a recursive version of the algorithm which finds the number of binary digits in a binary representation of a positive digital number. So the algorithms here, we are considering a decimal integer value n, and if n equal to 1, we will return 1. Otherwise, you divide that value by 2 and add 1 to that number. Okay, that is our binary recursion. So now you have to analyze the algorithm. How we analyze the algorithm? This is the algorithm. If n equal to 1, return 1, else return binary recursion n by 2 plus 1. So what is the here, what is the input size is n. Basic operation is n by 2 plus 1 is our basic operation.
Okay, now students, this is the representation. So how we perform the algorithm analysis for this algorithm. And so see the expression here, see the solving. So these algorithm analysis, I am considering A of N here. Okay, A of M is number of additions performed. In previous way, I am taking M of N for factorial and for factorial program, we are considering M of N multiplication. But here we are considering only additions, because binary of A of N by 2 plus additions are there. So that's why we are considering here additions only. Okay, see that. Okay students, tomorrow we will discuss the algorithm analysis, how we get A of N by 2 plus 1. Tomorrow we will discuss this thing. Today we end the class. Tomorrow we will discuss. Thank you. Anybody have any queries?